While there are benefits to AI, like providing creative inspiration and time savings, we know there is a lot of misinformation circulating the internet. For instance, there may be AI-generated content on social media platforms like Instagram and TikTok that you may not even realize was generated by AI. For example, I have used AI to help condense wordy captions or even sometimes to help me with my voiceover scripts. So Alyssa, can you share some of the ways AI and misinformation are connected?
Sure. So because AI can help users create content more easily and quickly, the risk of misinformation has increased.
Interesting. What would be your top three, say, examples when it comes to this?
So the first one is really around amplification and causing things to go viral. So AI-powered algorithms on social media platforms can often amplify and promote content based on user engagement. So the more people are liking and sharing, the more the AI algorithms are sending that information around. And so this can sort of by accident boost the visibility of information that's not true and make it spread more widely and reach a wider audience. The second one is around deepfakes and synthetic media. AI technology has advanced so much that it can be used to create very realistic and manipulated content like deepfakes, where images, videos, songs, text are manipulated to show something that didn't occur. And then these can be used to spread false information or even deceive people. And that makes it very challenging to distinguish what is real and what is AI generated. And the last one is about automatic content generation. AI can generate text, articles, or even chat conversations that mimic human-like language. And this capability could be exploited to create and share misinformation on a very large scale. And it makes it really, really hard to detect information that is not true.
Well, the three of us are very much real. And Sarah, do you have any tips or tricks for determining what AI is and what it isn't?
Of course. While I feel like it's tough to navigate, there are some steps that you and your kids can take to evaluate the information that's being generated from AI. And so first, you can identify the facts that are being presented to you. Are there any potential biases in that information? And is there any room for misinformation in what it is that you're reading or seeing? The second thing you can do is cross-check the information. And so do other sources say the same thing that you're looking at or that you're reading? And is there any conflicting information that's being presented? The next thing you can do is use fact-checking websites like Snopes or factcheck.org, or do a reverse Google image search. And then the final one is to consider all of the information that you've gathered and see, do these facts seem reasonable? Also remember that just because one fact is true in a piece of information or piece of content that you're consuming doesn't necessarily mean that all of the facts are true. And so it only takes a little extra time, but it's so important to make sure that the information that you're using is true and accurate. And so if something doesn't check out based on the points that I just mentioned, it's really best that you don't share it. We all play a part in stopping the spread of misinformation.
I love that. And I felt pretty comfortable with AI going into these conversations, but I feel like I've learned so much more from the both of you. So thank you for tuning into our series about AI. And if you're looking to learn more about AI, TELUS Wise has recently launched Responsible AI, a new online workshop for youth, which can be found at telus.com/wiseworkshops. The workshop was developed in collaboration with CIFAR. They offer an additional free course called Destination AI. It's a great place for youth, parents, or educators who want to learn even more about AI and what it means to Canadians. TELUS Wise workshops and resources cover a variety of topics, including AI, but also things like protecting your online security, privacy, and reputation, rising above cyberbullying, and using technology responsibly. I encourage you to visit telus.com/wise to learn more.